Sports. It's in the game.
We attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the options. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of pocket, but I rock with the game.
Attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. Strong in when he come in a slot. Trying to bend the corner, your limbs getting. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need to talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca there. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walking flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League is on the air. Straight ahead, we've got a good one on tap here between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the Los Angeles Rams. And off we go from SoFi Stadium. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. First carry for Najee Harris. And that is the kind of tackling they want to see all game, as he'll lose yardage to start things out. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. Throw. Westbrook. The completion good. This is Eric Ebron. That catch good for five. It's third down. That catch, by the way, number 505 of his career, and that ties him with a couple of other tight ends for the past, Frank Wycheck and Dallas Clark.
And those guys are excellent players, but how about what we're seeing right now? 505 and rising. What a nice career he's put together.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and six. Looking to throw. Westbrook, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. We always hear a lot of veterans on the defensive side of the football. They talk about smelling blood in the water, putting pressure on a rookie. They got to him there to force it free, but couldn't recover it.
And you mentioned the pressure. Rookie quarterback, you're going to bring more pressure at him at all times because you don't know how he's going to hold up. He was fortunate there. Luck was on his side, able to recover that fumble.
That'll go as a 42-yard punt, and they'll be aided by a loss of yardage on the return. And the Rams will go on offense here with a first and 10. They'll run. This is Jonathan Taylor. And he'll be brought down here at the 28. A solid run on first down. Gain of seven leaves him with a second and three. This defense for the Steelers, they were excellent a week ago in the victory over Arizona.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with three interceptions in that game.
They go play action with Hurts. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up third down. So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a third and three. They'll try and run for the first with Taylor. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And down he goes at the 45 after a pickup of nine.
And I think this is a route we'll see more of as this game goes on, because with his speed, they want to get him the ball in space on drag routes just like this. They want him to get the ball and run after the catch. Good job there, though, holding him for a short gain.
The play fake. Here's Hurts. This one complete to Mecole Hardman. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Well, from their point of view, this game could not be starting out much better, could it? force a punt on defense, and now they're moving it crisply on offense.
Crisply, I like that. Right, yeah, yeah, moving it very, very well. Looks like the defense on their heels a little bit. You put a score in here, long way to go, but you're right, that's a heck of a start.
Yeah, and I think this is where the play caller is looking at his play sheet and saying, grab that dagger play, grab that play and just finish them off right now, because I think they'd love to gain that big advantage early.
Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored gives yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30.
Well, they've certainly done a nice job spreading the ball around on this drive. This time he gets it out to his back, and it's another nice play and another first down. They've got the defense on their heels a little bit. They're reacting instead of being aggressive and making plays.
First and 10, Taylor now. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
Second down, another run with Taylor, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. Couple of nice carries back to back here, establishing the ground game a bit.
Yeah, these aren't bare bones runs now. I mean, they're getting substantial yardage, the kind of yard you're looking for, right? Let's go ahead and use a cliche. Stay ahead of the change, right? Five or more yards each time. That's what you're looking for in setting a tone and getting your offensive line going.
Good sign on the opening drive. On first and 10, it's Hurts. And this is caught. He's got a touchdown, LA. Jacob Harris hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Rams are going to take a first quarter lead. Rosas good with the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out with a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go. Well, he was a busy man out of the backfield a week ago. They got him the ball early and often. I have no doubt in my mind that he'll be a big part of the game plan here as well.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. It's a jet sweep. Here comes Claypool with it. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
I think the reason this play is so successful is not just the blocking at the point of attack, but how about the speed at which he takes the handoff? He's in motion already. So he's not coming from a flat start like a running back often is. He's at a full run by the time he gets the football.
So from Rams territory now, it's first and 10 at the 46. Snap comes in one. Now Haskins. Flush to his right. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Picked off at about the 31. And to the 40-yard line, that's where the return stops. So a first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Throwing is Hurts. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get, taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
They come up with exactly 1 minute to go in this first quarter. To throw on second and 10, Hurts. He'll get that complete to the tight end, Harris. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47. Now, after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. Not something you want to see in week 16 or any week, really. We'll be right back. The Steelers now in the nickel here on third down. Hurts taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that is caught at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, LA! Mecole Hardman, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Rams lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Rosas to add the extra point. And it's good, and they have jumped out here to a quick 14-0 first quarter lead. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Returning from his end zone is Ray McLeod. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities. I think the best offenses love to get the ball to their running backs in open space because they have the ability to make people miss, and they also have the ability to run over people. And if you do that throughout the game, after a while, they might just run through some of those tackles and go a long way.
Well, we saw him shed a nice tackle on that play. On second down, this is Harris, and he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain that time as it's going to leave him with a third and about 3 to go. Nothing to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he will have a Steelers first down. They needed 3. He doubled that. He got 6.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Back to throw. Westbrook, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Za'Darius Smith in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
Well, you're already up a couple of scores here in the first half defensively, and Charles, they just seem to be playing really free on that side of the football.
I love the observation because with that type of a lead, they feel like they can take a few more chances and be even more aggressive, and it's been paying off for them so far this game.
Looking to throw on second down. Westbrook. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third.
And that was yardage that they needed there after the sack on first down. They didn't get all of it back, but now they look at third down as a manageable situation, one that they have a much better chance of picking up.
From the gun, Haskins on third down. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 47. And his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
2nd down, another run with Taylor. And some room to work. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 57 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. He finds his man complete. It's Alexander. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
2nd down and 4. From the gun, it's Taylor. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's 1st and 10. Taylor. And this carry terminated at the 8-yard line. Good stick skills showing the power, but just not much room to operate. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. They'll try the left side with Taylor. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Call that a loss of a yard, and things get a little more difficult here, 3rd and 5. They give to Taylor out of the gun. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a pickup of 3, but it brings up what will be an interesting 4th and 1. They'll run for it. It's Taylor. There wasn't even thought of a short field goal. There was no hesitation. They were going for it.
I think he was thinking ahead a couple plays ago that if he got in this situation, they were definitely going for it. And you're right. It was a confident call and a decisive run to pick it up.
They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3 for 3 to start. Taylor. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. Jonathan Taylor, touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Rams tack on to their advantage. PAT up and good by Rosas. And it's now 21-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. Coming up at halftime, I'll go from one personality, that's you, Charles Davis, to another one in Orlando, the coach. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL. You and Jonathan Coachman, both larger than life.
No doubt about it.
But you're stuck with me. And the Rams got it. They bring him down. Za'Darius Smith racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top five. Now you add two more to his total.
The defense going to blanket the field. Six now in the secondary here for third and 15. Here's Haskins to throw. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. It'll be a gain of 12, but it will also lead to fourth down. Try and throw. Wide open receiver complete. And he finally is out of bounds, but he's down inside the 20-yard line. A big play there just before halftime. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Looking to throw. Westbrook. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
He did a fine job there of not hitting it before the ball arrived, and I've got to tell you, you can often mistime that play because of the angles of approach. When you're going to get him, sometimes you panic as well and think, I've got to be there right now. Instead, in this case, timed it perfectly and knocked it free.
Second and 10. They'll look to throw again. And that one will fall incomplete. Clock here now, just under 30 seconds to go in this first half. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing earlier in the drive in order to finish this one off.
Meanwhile, on third down, they take a shot at the end zone, but it's incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
Now Chris Boswell for the Steelers' field goal try. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. Boswell's kick is good, and the deficit drops now from 21 down to 18. So they do get the 3 points before they hit halftime. Something to build on, maybe.
Yeah, go ahead and raise the banner, right? Wave the flag. That's good. Got points. And now, as you said, they've got something to build on as they get ready for the second half.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room. He'll find his running back, Edwards-Helaire. The Rams going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Hurts to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Taylor. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. And this offense going to elect to burn a timeout with 5 seconds remaining in quarter number two. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. This was the old NFL record distance for decades, a 63-yard attempt. And that one's not going to get there. Not enough juice, an ambitious effort, but it's well short. And this score will stay right where it is. The long-distance shot before break comes up empty, but now Charles flipped the script. Time for likely one more play as field position becomes an issue.
Yeah, when you talk about field position, remember, if this kick is missed, the ball comes back to where? The spot that they snapped it from, so field position becomes a factor. I think at this spot, you might also want to think about throwing the Hail Mary. You know, put the ball up in the air, maybe you can get six out of it instead of three.
Yeah, see what happens. And he's going to be taken down here as that will lead us to the end of the first half of play. So we've reached halftime here. Let's throw in a broadcaster cliche, shall we? Both teams looking for a gift on Christmas Eve. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. A carry by Taylor to start the drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 94 yards rushing for him so far as his terrific season continues here. One play has him up past the 40 already and another first and 10. Play action, here's Hurts. And the catch made by Hopkins. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
And a nice milestone reached on that last throw is here late in the season. He goes over 4,000 yards passing.
And he's really thrown the ball well all season long. Had some big games along the way. He's inspired his receiving core to go out and make plays for him in each and every ball game.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Catch is made by Hardman, and he takes this just a few yards shy of the red zone before going out. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
But first down, Hurts. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Taylor. Touchdown! Jonathan Taylor
with touchdown number 23 here on the year.
And the Rams take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead.
Rosas good with the extra point, and they open the lead up now to 25. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. A run with Harris out of the shotgun. A very tough run, but for a pretty short gain out near the 32. They follow up the gain of five by only getting one there on second down. Haskins will throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Harris. And he will have a Steelers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. And it looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. Not something you want to see in week 16 or any week, really. We'll be right back. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Now the former fourth-round pick, it's Kalen Ballage.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Midfield now, Haskins. He finds his target, Ebron. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
There's a nice pickup right there, and after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. Now Ballage. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And it'll be second and very short. Throw. Westbrook. This one into the hands of the running back, Ballage. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game, because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long, but a nice throw there for a good gain and a first down.
Balazs. And able to get him inside the five here, just inside the five to about the four. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. Again to the brother of J.J. This is Derek Watt. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the one-yard line. They go with Watt again, the fullback. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Derek Watt hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Steelers are able to cut into that deficit. Well, good with the extra point, and that'll cut the lead down to 18. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And now you've got the clock winding down here in the third quarter. You're three scores to the good. What's your approach on this drive?
Too early to fully commit to playing the clock game. Yet at the same time, you're also not going pell-mell like you would in two-minute offense. This is what NFL offense is called, four-minute football. Take the clock out of the game a little bit, wind it down, but at the same time, keep advancing the ball down the field.
Third quarter action, and we appreciate you spending your Christmas Eve right here with us. Second and 10. They go to the ground again with Taylor. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
On third down, here's Taylor. And Taylor, I don't think he got there. No, he did not. Unable to break free, and he's marked short. No gain there on the play, and that's going to leave him with a fourth down. We're off to the fourth quarter here on Christmas Eve. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Johnny Hecker now. Always a good sign when your first punt comes in the fourth quarter. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. And the fair catch is taken at about the 13-yard line here. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Steelers are going to take over first and 10 deep in their own territory. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. Remember, they have won three straight, but getting to four straight does not appear to be in the cards as they are in a big fourth quarter hole. They'll start with a give here to Balazs. And he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, 5 yards on that run. Let's get back to the huddle and make sure if you're back, you spend time with your offensive line and give them credit. Hard to move those 300-plus pounders at the line of scrimmage, and they did for a significant chunk of yardage.
Check 26, check 26.
They'll stay on the ground. Balazs again.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down.
But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
The Steelers on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Now it's Haskins. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he will lose yardage on the play. Back at his own 19-yard line. They're calling a loss of a yard there. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. That's to his running back, complete. And he will have the first down, but he winds up paying for it pretty good. Fourth down, trailing in the fourth quarter. They felt compelled to go for it, and they got it.
Well, I'd look down at my play sheet, and what I would find, plays that have been successful throughout the game that have worked at the distance you need, and that's exactly what they got done.
They'll run here with Balazs. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
To throw on second down. Westbrook into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 48, and he'll bring this one back to the 29. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful. They get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
126 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. They'll run here with Taylor. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd and goal. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up 3rd down. Try and run, Taylor. And he is out of bounds here. A good run that time. They couldn't close him down, and now 9 yards makes for a very different situation on 4th and goal. Taylor, and he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams.
Jonathan Taylor with another touchdown, number 24 on the year. And the Rams are closing in on a third straight win as they widen the gap further here in the fourth quarter. PAT up and good by Rosas. And they open the lead up now to 25. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. The football will come out to the 25 as McLeod will not return it. The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack them here.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And that one almost intercepted. Could have been his third pick of the game. Instead, it's going to bring up a third down. Steelers on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Looking to throw. Westbrook escaping the pressure right. He gets this one to Johnson. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th.
You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
Gotta try it here. He's back to throw. And he'll be brought down with the first down and a late flag here, too. And he may get a few more tacked on for good measure. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they'll march off another 15 against your squad.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Rams have got it back.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely.
Pick of the game, but it falls down to the ground incomplete.
Charles, you said earlier this defense is probably going to need to hold these guys right around 20 or under that if they were going to have a chance. It was evident pretty early on that wasn't going to happen.
Yeah, they left 20 behind a long time ago in this game, didn't they? It looks like they're headed towards a big, big number. But 20 was the threshold because that kept them in the ball game and kept the pressure off of their own offense.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So it's Rams football here as we get you reset. And they have just about put this one on ice as they've got it here, first and 10.
140 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now.
Second down, another run with Taylor. No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. So the L.A. Rams with a victory here. And this coaching staff, CD, I think you'd agree, pleased with this overall effort.
I think they're more than pleased, right? They've got to look at each other like, wow, we just pulled this one off in a big way. Great job.